Welcome to season two of Between Two Nerds. I'm Mike.
I'm Adam.
And we have our guest here.
Mark Beluscak.
And Mark, what do you do?
I am the new director of the Law Enforcement Academy here at Red Rocks Community College.
Wow. Well, welcome.
Thank you.
That's awesome.
It's a pleasure to have you here.
Yeah, Thank you.
So what does that involve?
Well, there's about a billion moving pieces. There's scheduling of instructors and students and permits and lots of paperwork.
Wow. Yeah. Lots of paperwork. Do you get to go out on the cars and, you know?
Sometimes I do. Yeah. That's a good question.
Do you work with the canines? Because Loki thinks he should be a canine dog.
You know, Loki would be perfect. I think we could take Loki out, teach him to be a bomb-sniffing dog, actually.
Oh, I don't know if he wants to do that.
That sounds
no.
Dangerous.
He just wants to be one of those scary-looking dogs that, you know, keeps people safe.
Loki, do you want to be one of those dogs? Can you chase down bad criminals?
Yes, he could.
I can see
especially
that.
If they have food, you know? So
do they do, like, do you work with the students in, like, reenactments or, like, demonstrations and things like that?
So the academy is really based on several areas. There's an academic area, and then there's the three main skills areas. So there's driving, shooting, and arrest control. Pretty simple, learning how to drive in emergency situations, learning how to shoot a gun, and then learning how to do all the arrest control tactics that police officers do. And there's the academic portion, constitutional law, learning how to approach vehicles safely. We're all about the safety. Wow.
I bet that's really hard. Just, you know, all the procedures people have to do to make sure they do things right and they don't make decisions too quickly, but they react adequately to a situation.
Well, in the situations, there's so much adrenaline.
Yeah.
Like keeping it all in your mind while you're also, like, fitting in the protocol.
It's pretty huge. They, you know, they really have a lot to keep, you know, all straight, and by the end, they have to take a test, and if they don't pass that test, they're not certified. So there's a state certification test that they are gearing up to take.
And the test, is it like, is it a written test, or is there a demonstration test, or a little bit of both?
It's a written, you know, just a couple hundred questions and multiple choice, and if they pass, great. If they don't pass.
So what brings you out to Colorado? How long have you been out here? And
been out here since November of 1992.
Okay,
left Ohio, as everyone should.
Yeah. Ohio Chamber of Commerce. This is your guy right here.
Ohio is a great place to be from. And I came out as a national park ranger. And I worked in Yellowstone National Park.
Let's just keep going.
Qualification for nerd or, I mean?
You know, I think you have some creds that you were telling me about.
Yeah, we have three.
Because, well, no, you're a ham radio?
I am a ham radio operator, which is the prime nerd hobby.
Yeah,
certified ham radio operator.
Do you make ham radios? Like, actually wire them up and everything?
I'm not that smart, but I can work on some basic stuff, but mostly everything today is transistors.
And I really want to
not really vacuum tubes anymore. Like
That's cool.
That is cool. Yeah. You know, we got the Cleveland thing, the ham radio thing. What made you go into law enforcement?
You know, truthfully, never wanted to go into law enforcement. My undergraduate is in education. I wanted to be a teacher. And so I started out at Ohio State University. Yay, go Buckeyes.
Oh, yeah, whatever.
What do you mean, whatever?
No.
That's fine. Yeah,
fine institution.
And then I became a law enforcement park ranger just to kind of work in between summers. And then I got hired by the sheriff of Summit County after I went down for a summer, and he had me patrol Dillon Reservoir. And I said, okay, well, at least I'm still doing kind of park ranger type stuff.
Yeah.
And then the chief of Silverthorn heard of me, saw me, and said, why don't you come and work for the town of Silverthorn? And I said, okay, I'm not really a big city police officer, still a small town police officer, still kind of fun, kind of park ranger-ish up in the mountains. And then Denver made me an offer I couldn't refuse.
Oh my gosh.
And so I went to work for the city and county of Denver.
But you've had some unusual cases.
Oh yeah.
Can you give us, you know, without, I mean, you know.
Unusual, I mean, do you mean as in
quirky
the
or
supernatural? Or
do you have supernatural?
Supernatural cases? Okay, yeah, okay. You've got one. Let's go with that one.
All right. Please.
So the Molly Brown house was in my jurisdiction. And that place really is haunted. And you could, even though everything is completely locked down and locked up at night, if you're standing next to it, you do hear things coming out of the Molly Brown house.
Whoa.
So you could just go down, well, if I just went and stood outside the gate there.
At night, everything is completely locked down and solid. You should not hear anything, and yet you hear things.
Like what?
People walking around.
Oh my goodness.
People like knocking on windows.
So did you work on the mall, the 16th Street Mall?
I did. I was the neighborhood police officer for the 16th Street Mall.
Really?
So I was there pretty specifically.
You would go meet
years.
The businesses?
Talk to the businesses, yeah. Talk to the people.
Streets. That's great. So it's almost like the beat cop, but now you're on a bike.
That's exactly what a neighborhood police officer does for the city of Denver.
That's really cool. That's really cool. So do you think we're good? Should we just sign off at this point? Yeah. So anyway, thank you, Mark. This has been really interesting.
I hope so. Yeah.
I think we got multiple episodes
gaps.
Out of this
oh,
one.
Yeah, episodes.
Oh, gaps. Well, anyway, thank you, and thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time, Between Two Nerds.